Good morning, everybody. Jim Hoffman here. I am pastor at St. John's United Methodist Church in Midtown, Kansas City. It is time for our daily devotion. So I want to invite you to come and join me as we gather together just in the middle of our day to spend a little bit of time with God. Looking forward to this time with you. As you join, leave a quick comment, say hello. I would appreciate you doing that. If you watch this later on today or sometime maybe in the next couple of days, leave a quick comment and say hello. I appreciate you doing that. It tells me who all has a time to, you know, who just stops by and spends time with us in our devotions. So I appreciate all of that. Pretty simple format for us in our daily devotions. We start with a prayer. We read from the scriptures that's for today, then the upper room devotion, take a moment to reflect upon it, and then we close in prayer. Usually about 10 minutes is our time or so that we take for our devotions. So don't spend a lot of time on it, but just enough, I think, for us to find that good solace and break that we need. We're reading from Psalm 19 today, by the way. Psalm 19, we're reading the last 8 verses, verses 7 to 14. So if you want to find that, Psalm 19, beginning in verse 7, we'll read to the end of the chapter. Hi, Barbara and Chris. Good morning to both of you. It's a cloudy Saturday here. Actually, kind of partly cloudy. It's kind of breaking up a little bit, but we had just a tad bit of rain overnight. We could certainly use more. Psalm 19, beginning in the 7th verse. We'll wait just a little bit longer and then we'll get started. Psalm 19. All right, here's our opening prayer from Peacemaking Through Worship. It is a prayer written by Jane Parker Huber. O God, by your spoken word, you created everything that is. By your incarnate word, you redeemed us. By your comforting word, you are with us still. So prepare us now to hear your word to us this day. Amen. Psalm 19, beginning in the 7th verse, reads, "The instructions of the Lord are perfect, reviving the soul. The decrees of the Lord are trustworthy, making wise the simple. The commandments of the Lord are right, bringing joy to the heart. The commandments of the Lord are clear, giving insight for living. Reverence for the Lord is pure, lasting forever. The laws of the Lord are true, each one is fair. They are more desirable than gold, even the finest gold. They are sweeter than honey, even honey dripping from the comb. They are a warning to your servant, a great reward for those who obey them. How can I know all the sins lurking in my heart? Cleanse me from these hidden faults. Keep your servant from deliberate sins. Don't let them control me. Then I will be free of guilt and innocent of great sin. May the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be pleasing to you, O Lord, my rock and my redeemer." Our devotion writer today is John D. Brown, and John is from Minnesota. His focus verse comes out of James chapter 1, verse 5, which says, "If any of you lacks wisdom, you should ask God, who gives generously to all without finding fault, and it will be given to you." So here's John's devotion for today. During my career, I had the opportunity to give numerous presentations. Over the years, I've also had the pleasure of giving the sermon at my church on many occasions, and the preparation process I used at work has helped me put together sermons as well. Recently, I was getting ready to work on a new sermon, and it dawned on me that I was overlooking the critical first step. I was immediately jumping into my standard preparation routine for coming up with a topic, working on the message, and then asking God to bless it. How much better is it to start off by consulting God in prayer, seeking God's will, asking for guidance, rather than just launching off on my own? I believe the principle of first praying to God applies to any task or challenge we face. Instead of just jumping in and relying on our own efforts, we can make it a practice to start with prayer. The words from Proverbs offer good advice. Trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not into your own understanding. For in all your ways submit to Him, and He will make your paths straight. Proverbs 3, 5, and 6. So the thought for the day is, today I will begin each new task with prayer. Now, let's talk about this for a moment. You can certainly be a person who prays before every single thing that you undertake. And if you desire to do that, God bless you. If you can maintain that, God bless you. If you can't maintain that, don't get down on yourself. Because that's a pretty high bar. That's a pretty high standard to say that I'm going to pray before every single task or thing that I do. Maybe what you could do is think of it this way. The important things that you're going to do in your life start out with prayer. So let's say you need to make a major decision, like a health decision, or maybe it's a move or something to do with your finances. Maybe start with prayer for those, the really big things that are in your life, the big decisions. Maybe start with prayer for each of those. I would also say that you need to start with a prayer of thanksgiving. Maybe you start your day with a prayer of thanksgiving, just the task of the day itself. Maybe the first thing you do is when you roll out of bed and you're making your cup of coffee, you say, "Thank you, Lord, for another day." Maybe you take a moment to pray over your meals because God has provided generously, and you are one of the fortunate people in our world that has the opportunity to eat more than just one meal during the day. And maybe we need to be thankful for those kinds of things as well. And then when we come to the big challenges, the big tasks, the heavy lifts, we come to God asking for God to lead. Otherwise, we just simply go based upon our own understanding. We go based upon our own experiences of how we have navigated through life and the places where we've been successful, the things that we've used as our tools to do that, or the people that we've also used as well. And we try to figure out how to navigate these things, thinking I'm more than capable. And yet, we find out, unfortunately, that sometimes we're not as capable. Sometimes things happen to us. And maybe if we had started out with prayer, we might have had God's wisdom. We might have been a little bit more in tune to the Spirit. We might have listened with our spiritual eyes a little better because we've already engaged God in the process. And so I would encourage you to think about what it is that you are trusting in the Lord with all your heart for. And the areas of your life where you are leaning not just simply into your own understanding, but rather you're submitting to God who can make our paths straight. And know that when we ask God for wisdom, I believe God will give it to us. So what are you praying for today? That's a big thing, a heavy lift, a task, something that's going on in your lives, something that you need to consult God for. I want to encourage you to take a moment to pause and pray for those things. And I want to encourage you to take a moment to be thankful, to pause and pray for what we may say are the small things. and yet are a reminder that God provides for all of our needs. Let's take a moment to pause and pray as we close, friends. So, dear God, thank you for creating us to be in relationship with you. Help us always to seek your wisdom and your will for our lives. And we pray this in Christ. Amen. Thank you, friends, for being here today, Barbara and Chris. I'm glad I got to hang out with the two of you. For those of you that stop by later on today, don't forget, leave a quick comment, as I said earlier. Let me know that you were present. I would appreciate you doing that. Once we finish with our live event here, you are more than welcome to share this on your own Facebook page if you would like. Maybe one of your family and friends will stop by and have a moment to spend in devotions with us today. I'm praying for you today, friends. I want to invite you to take a moment to pray for me. Also, certainly pray for one another as a community. Appreciate you doing that. And then I want to remind you, tomorrow, worship at St. John's. Our times are 8:30 in the chapel, 10:45 for our sanctuary service. We also stream our sanctuary service, and that can be found on christianworldmedia.com. And then you just search for St. John's UMC-Kansas City, and you will find us, and you can watch if you are not in the Kansas City area. But if you are at home and you are healthy and you are able, I would invite you to come join us in the sanctuary. Be present with us in your community. And if you are someone that lives out of the area but you have a church home, go see your folks. Be with them tomorrow for your worship time. And then we'll be back on Monday for devotions, so don't forget about that. Come and join us each day next week for our devotion time. God's peace and grace be upon you. I look forward to being with you soon, and thank you for being here today.